The Knights, you may begin your performance in finals competition.
It is not a day for politics. I have saved this one opportunity to speak briefly to you about the mindless menace of violence in America, which again stains our land and every one of our lives.
I don't have to tell you things aren't good. Everybody knows things aren't good. We know the air is unfit to breathe and our food is unfit to eat. Young punks are running the street, no one knows just what to do, and there's no end to it. The dollar buys a penny's worth, banks are going under, cobblers keeping a gun under the counter. We sit watching our idiot boxes while some local anchorman tells us that today we've had 18 murders and 80 violent crimes, as if that were the way things were supposed to be. We know times are bad, worse than bad. People are crazy. It's like everything everywhere is going utterly mad, so we never leave our homes. We sit in our comfy abodes while the world is getting smaller, and we say, come on, at least leave us alone in our family rooms. Let me have my microwave and flat screen and my 20-inch wheels, and I won't say anything. Just leave us alone. Well, I'm not gonna leave you alone. I don't want you to get angry. I don't want you to riot. I don't want you to protest. I don't want you to write your senator, because I don't know what to tell you to tell him. I don't know what to do about the recession and the inflation and the crime in the street. All I know is that you've got to get mad. You've got to say,
this is no time to engage in the luxury of cooling off or to take the tranquilizing drug of gradualism. Now is the time to make real the promises of the government. Now is the time.
We as a people peace and security, we support you. And to all those who have wondered if America's beacon still burns as bright, tonight we prove once more that the true strength of our nation comes not from the might of our arms or the scale of our wealth, but from the enduring power of our ideals, democracy, liberty, opportunity, and unyielding hope. We have seen so much, but there's so much more to do. So tonight, let us ask ourselves, if our children should live to see the next century, what change will they see? What progress will we have made? This is our chance to answer that call. This is our moment. This is our time.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Knights from Orlando, Florida. They're under the direction of Michael L. James.